morning queen. What a beautiful being. Raising two wonderful kings. Yeah. Oh, 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 oh. Said you're a melanin queen. What a beautiful being. Yeah. Raising two wonderful kings. Yeah, yeah.
So it's actually been quite a while since I've been here with any cash stuffing or anything like that. And today I just kind of wanted to talk about that. And also, I'm also going to be showing you guys some of the stuff that I've been working on.
As in case y'all are wondering, like, why is this weirdo wearing gloves?
First things first, as far as my absence goes, I have not been cash stuffing, just because I've had a lot going on in my life. You know, life throws you curveballs and you swing, you know. It's kind of hard for me to talk just because I don't know what I want to put out there and what I don't want to put out there. But I do want to say that I've been dealing with kind of some lemons, and I'm just doing my best to make lemonade. So as far as cash stuffing, my income hasn't really been as steady as I like it, because I had to switch jobs. So I no longer work at my old job, and I won't be cash stuffing once a week anymore. Or you know what? I still might. I've been thinking about it today. I still might try to cash stuff at least once a week. What I'll do is probably just try to like split my payments or something like that, just so I have content coming out steadily. So like I said, I've just been dealing with a lot of things in my life and trying to figure things out. The money that I had saved up, that's what I've been using to survive. Thankfully, my next check is coming in pretty soon. So that's kind of a good thing. I've had to like resituate myself and just kind of get things together, but I'm not complaining about it, you know, because I could be in a lot worse position. But I'm not. So I'm just thankfully I had, you know, my cash envelopes to fall back on, and they came into play right when I needed. Unfortunately, it's not for what I was planning them to be used for, but that's okay. At least I had the cushion to you know, help me stay afloat. Because for the most part, I'm a pretty open person, but I still kind of like to keep some things to myself. And maybe one day I'll be at a point where I would like to, you know, open up and share the entire story, but unfortunately that time is not now. So my cash binders haven't been getting stuffed, but I do keep my main binder with me, and I have been utilizing the envelopes as far as that, you know, to kind of keep things, stretched and stuff like that. I haven't been using my wallet that I used to use to shop out of, because I've just been holding on to the money that I originally had and trying to take care of everything to keep my household afloat, from there. So again, there's no complaints, just making the best with what I can, with what I have, what I'm given. That being said, I've also been investing a lot into myself. I've been investing a lot into my business and, you know, chasing my dreams and my goals and manifesting a healthy reality for myself. I don't really have too much more to say about my situation. If y'all have any questions and I'm comfortable answering them, of course, I'll let you know. Just, you know, ask me below. Let's move on to the next part of this video. I don't want to make it too long, but I do want to put something out there. But I just wanted to talk to you about my shop. Okay, so I know originally I had my Etsy shop, but Etsy was like crickets. Like, there's nothing going on for me on Etsy, and I, you know, I didn't do the best with promoting it, and it was really hard for me to figure out how to set up their platform and utilize their platform to my it was just hard for me to utilize their platform. So I was exploring options, and I had thought about, like, maybe I'm just not, you know, cut for this, you know, online shop stuff. So I was gonna, you know, quit that, but there was a lot of girls here locally that would see my binders, like, when I would go out, and they would, you know, ask me about them, and they'd be like, oh, do you make them? And, you know, no, I don't make them, sorry. It was just something, a fun little project for me, and a lot of people just kept encouraging me that I should make them. So then I came back and to the drawing board, and I just explored different platforms and things that I could utilize to maybe set up a new shop. Well, I came across a website that kind of, or a platform that really helped me to set up my site the way that I think, well, that I understand, and I think is easier for the consumer to understand. That being said, I wanted to talk about some of the things that I have available on my website. I did actually have some orders that I filled, but I already shipped them off, and I'm just like, dang, I should have thought about this video before I shipped them off. I'll try to find, I did take some TikToks of them, so I'll try to insert those TikToks of them, and so y'all can see how they came out. One of them came out, well, both of them came out beautiful, but there's this one envelope that I just keep thinking about, and it's this butterfly envelope that I made, and I love the way it came out, and I just want to make like a butterfly themed binder. Here's the crazy thing. Every time I make a binder or make envelopes or anything, I'm like, ooh, I should redo my binders. Like, no, because I'll be redoing my binders all the time. I don't know where to start first. Of course, you have, you know, your cash envelopes and your binders. So those are obviously there. But let me show you some of the pens that I have available. So I have the pretty much typical, you know, pen of the budgeting community, the one with the big rhinestone at the top. So I have this one, and I found some, I have some really cute, I found this really cute butterfly one. I just, adorable. But I think this one has sold the most. And then here's another one of the giant rhinestone ones, but it's just white and gold. Another butterfly one. This is so pretty. I love this pen. So here's another butterfly one. All right. And then we have, this is something that I just found out I could do, but this is basically a rhinestone pen. And then look at that, I've put the vinyl onto the pen so you can personalize them. And that's an option that I have available on my website. So yeah, most of the time, I know my website, or not I know, but my website is Babes and Budgets. But I didn't want to put budget too much all over stuff, because I feel like, not that's embarrassing, but I just feel like, I don't know, people might think of it as being cheap. So that's why I decided to put boss instead of budget. But on one thing, I did keep the budget, because that's the whole goal. This is my personal pen. That's why it doesn't have wrapper. It goes with my bills binder. Sorry, I'm putting that in there right now. But I did put budget on one thing, and that is my Budget Babe, this 1K placeholder. Why did I say this? 1K placeholder. It has a little hole in it just because I had it hanging on my wall, because I'm determined to get to, this is my first goal, $1,000 in my shop. But not there yet, so I'm gonna keep going, but just come in here, or not come in here, but just come look at it every day, and you know, it's just helped me stay into the mindset of don't give up, you know? If I quit on me, then everybody else is going to quit on me. And nobody's going to believe in me like I believe in me, besides maybe my sons, you know? But anyways, so this one does say, it says budget, and then it says babe. And I decided to keep this on the 1K placeholders just because that's part of our community, you know? And it's just like, the 1K placeholders seem to be a goal for everyone. And that just means, like, to me that you're doing a good job, you know? So that's this. I also have plain ones available, and I can also laminate them for you if you like. If you want them laminated, I cannot put the rhinestones on there, or maybe I can. I just don't know if they'll stay. But yeah, so I also invested in these cash trays. So they're just like little clear trays. And this one I customized for me, and it says Boss Babe on there. And I just put the little jewels on there because I really wanted to keep the vinyl, but I also did want a little bit of like dazzle on there, jewels, whatever, bling. So I put a little bit there because I didn't want it to be completely blinged out. I did that with another thing that I'm going to be selling. And personally, I like it more. I'm a little simplistic, minimalistic. There you go. Let's call it that. I'm a little minimalistic. So I did that with another project or item that I'll be selling. And I feel like I don't like it. It's just not my personality type. So here is, let's move into that actually, what I'm talking about. So I will be selling tumblers as well. And the whole point of me selling tumblers is so that way they can be customized. So here's the tumbler. I also have a clear one, a stainless steel. What other colors do I have over there? Pink and purple. And my personal one is blue. Okay, so this is what the tumbler looks like. The straw, you can't lose it. I mean, unless you intentionally like take it out because it has this little notch on it. But it's double walled. They're double walled tumblers. So yeah, what I did with mine, or I don't even know if I want to keep it just because, like I said, it's not my style. But I was planning to just because it was my first time bedazzling something or jeweling something or blinging something. And I feel like I'm going to be honest with y'all, and I'm going to show you the real issue that I have with this. My real issue is this. I wish I would have chose a thicker font because, or maybe I wish I would have chosen a darker, like colors that contrast more. Okay, so here it is. But you see how you can barely see the pink in here? So either the font needs to be thicker so that way you can see the pink more, or yeah, that's really the only option, you know? So that's probably my only problem. I probably should have went like on the outside a little more, something like that, to make it a little bigger. But it was my first time. I know better now. But I'm pretty proud of like my honeycomb pattern. That I think came out pretty good. So that looks pretty good to me. But yeah, so this is the cup. It's like I said, it's not really my style, but I was planning on keeping it just because I don't feel comfortable selling it. But just, I don't know, it was my first time. It's kind of sentimental. And it says, with all the rest of my stuff says, Boss Babe, you know? Yeah, so I was just thinking about maybe I should hold on to it. But if not, then I'll probably sell it for a discounted price, you know? This took me actually a little while too. It took me like, maybe eight hours? Yeah. 8 hours. About 8 hours. So yeah. So those are available on my website. Sorry, I'm trying to put this over here. I also have the little fuzzy keychains. and I can do custom acrylic hearts on them. This looks like all cloudy and scratchy, but I promise you it's not. They just have little thin strips of plastic over them to protect the actual actual heart shape. So, so I have the little keychains, and I've been attaching them to my binders, you know, as like little charms or whatever. I see that, you know, that kind of, not that kind of happens a lot in the community, but I see that girls like the like book charm things. So yeah, so I have the keychains available as well in case if you don't want to buy a whole binder just to get a keychain. And yeah, that's pretty much everything that I think I have on my site besides, of course, my envelopes and binders and stuff like that. And we have graduated from the sticker and tape sticker and tape phase. Okay, we've moved on. We're out of that phase. Thankfully, that did not happen to too many people. We are at a better stage in life. We are leveling up. But I still love my binders. They're still holding up for me. So they've been good to me. So the tape or the stickers haven't started peeling. So I'm all good to go. Let me see. Is there anything else that I want to cover? I don't think I really want to cover too much of anything else. My website is www.babesandbudgets.com. That's it. Babesandbudgets.com. There's a launch sale going on right now, and it's 30% off. So I think that's pretty decent for, you know, just opening up, going into business. I'd really like it if you girls could check it out, or guys, if y'all could check it out and just let me know what you think, or maybe order something. I think there's something for everyone there. Just check out the website. I'm honestly kind of in a little bit of pain. My stomach is hurting really bad. So I'm gonna go ahead and just end this video here. And with me trying to balance everything back out in my life, hopefully I'll be getting back to cash stuffing really soon. Or not hopefully, I will be getting back to cash stuffing really soon. Like I said, my first check is coming up, but I have some bills that check is basically gone between bills and, you know, and groceries to keep things going here. You guys have a great day. I'm so happy to be back making videos. I did have one babe who contacted me, and she was like, hey, I've been looking for you on YouTube, you know, and I just thought that was so sweet. And I really do appreciate those of you who like really genuinely look out for me. I appreciate that. My bitch is all bad, my niggas all real. I ride in his dick in some big tall heels. Big fat checks, big large bills. Run out, flip like 10 car wheels. Cold ass bitch, I give raw chills. 10 different looks and my looks so kill. I guess I'm in. Be honest, something I ain't giving you.
Left foot, right foot, levitating. Pop stars, do a leap with the baby. I had to lace my shoes for all the blessings I was chasing. If I ever slip, I fall into a better situation. So catch up, go put some cheese on it. Get out and get your bread up. They always leave when you fall, but you run.
Get your dreams, baby, get you and me. It's time to boss up. Fix your credit, girl, get at it. Get your bag up. Hit that gym and get back fine. Go get that degree, go girl, focus on me. Unlock potential that you didn't know you had in you. Fuck that nigga, ay! Oh yeah, it's time to mix it up and get your glow, girl. I know that you gon' get it, you got so much. Don't let nobody tell you that it's over. I want you to know that, girl, you got it, you got it. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. You got it, you got it. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, you my little baby. I'm gon' make it known. Let that nigga hate. Girl, what is he gon' do? Get back your honor. It's
soon.